Thanks for letting me hitch a ride over.
No problem. You sure we can't drive you back?
Nah, you're like stretching my legs. It isn't far. And anyway, can't put the wind in a bottle.
All right.
Tessa should be at her parents' grave, not far from the entrance. Look for a big, crooked tree. You can't miss it. I'm gonna go check in with my uncle. Good luck. For real.
You look pretty spooked.
I've never been a big fan of cemeteries. Especially after, you know.
I promise after this we can chill at the house, cool?
Okay, dann gehe ich halt vor. Ein großer, krummer Baum. Warum ich eigentlich jetzt dem Weg lang gehe, der war jetzt auf jeden Fall. Ja, okay, Entschuldigung, es war jetzt so gerade verführerisch gewesen.
So, did you ever come back?
Shh, keep it down.
Better?
Much.
Why do people always feel like they have to whisper in cemeteries?
I don't know. Probably just a mirror neuron thing.
A what?
Monkey see, monkey do.
Yeah. Anyway, have you been back here at all since the funeral?
No. I've never had a reason to. Thankfully.
Oh, hier haben wir irgendwo eine Erinnerung. Da.
Mom, why do we always come here?
Does it bother you?
No, it's just weird because we don't know any of these people. I mean, except Eddie's mom.
It never hurts to say hello.
Because they're very lonely.
That's right, sweetie. And sometimes, even if you can't see them, they stay with you. In here. Always here.
Mom?
Always.
She loved us. A lot. But sometimes it was like loving us hurt her.
Do you think she was just really scared of losing us?
Maybe. Yeah. But I don't know. I mean, most parents are scared of losing their kids.
Ich will mich eher fragen, warum wir auf dem Friedhof fahren, weil wir hatten vorhin kurz mal das Gespräch gehabt über den Vater der Kinder. Vielleicht besucht sie jemanden speziellen, wo sie aber nicht sagen wollte, wer es sein könnte. Aufgrund des nationalen Verbots einheimischer Religion und Riten ist ein großer Teil unseres Wissens über das spirituelle Leben der Tlingit verloren gegangen. Unten befinden sich zwei unvergängliche Beispiele der Liebe und Ehrfurcht, die wir den Toten in der Tradition unserer Ahnen weiterhin zeigen. Gut, das lesen wir uns jetzt, er sagt jetzt hier nicht durch. Feiert das Leben. Ja, aber wie gesagt, die schaue ich mir jetzt nicht an. Ich denke mal nicht, dass wir das Rätsel damit lösen können. Und viel wichtiger ist natürlich jetzt erstmal zu gucken, wo haben wir denn den krummen Baum?
Well, here's the crooked tree, but no Tessa.
Let's check around for her parents' grave. Just to make sure this is the right spot.
You think it's possible Michael remembered it wrong?
Well, I've done inventory with him before, so yes.
Wait, is this the one we called Big Crookedy?
The exact one.
Why didn't we call it Gnarls Branching? Total missed opportunity.
Because we weren't hip to basketball back then? Or CeeLo Green?
Damn. I remember it going all...
De Leon.
That's the one!
Don't tell me we missed her.
Hello, Mr. Eagle.
Kids. It's time.
Für was ist es Zeit? Hä? Ach da.
I can walk fine on my own.
It'll be quick, okay? Then we'll get something to eat.
The day of the funeral. I barely remember it.
That's probably for the best. I don't think either of us are exactly eager to relive what went on behind that gate.
So, I know I said we didn't have to visit her grave.
But it feels like the right thing to do.
Yeah, exactly.
Können wir uns die anderen Gräber jetzt ja auch nur angucken? Wir trampeln zwar mal auf den Grab hier rum, aber okay. Gut, sagt mir gar nichts. Ich glaube, wir müssen das auch einfach nur das Grab der beiden finden. Aber Tessa ist, wie gesagt, nicht hier zu sehen. War aber auch ziemlich auffällig gewesen, da die Vase, die da nur stand. Die Tür ist wieder offen. Klopf, klopf. Nein, da können wir nicht durch. Aber dann wird Tessa 100 pro zu dem Grab von Mary Ann gegangen sein.
Do you remember where she is?
No.
Oh, Leute.
It's worth, I remember staring at the water during the funeral.
Bei der Beerdigung aus Wasser geschaut, müsste er hier irgendwo sein.
Allison, come back!
Yeah. Any hope that this would be easier than last time? Totally gone.
At least this time no one's sending me away.
I'm holding you to that.
Ach, guck mal, das, Tessa.
You and I had a moment over there by the totem, right? I wonder if we could see that.
Doesn't hurt to check.
Ist doch Tessa, oder?
Oh. Hi.
Nee.
I didn't see you there.
I'm sorry. We didn't mean to eavesdrop.
No harm done. Hey, you're that nice gal from the Becky store. Allison, right?
Yes. And you're... It starts with a K, right?
Kendra. Don't worry. Don't expect you to keep track of everyone who passes through. And you would be...
Her brother. I'm Tyler.
Pleased to meet you, Tyler.
I hope this isn't rude, but where's that accent from?
Georgia. Born and raised. Landed in Delos about 2 years ago.
From Georgia to the middle of nowhere, Alaska. There's gotta be a story there.
Well, I wasn't planning to stay for more than a few months. We came up for the fishing season, just like we'd done twice before. My husband, Meech, he always tried to convince me to stay on longer, but I wasn't having it. But then, well, we lost him. Fishing accident.
Oh, God. I'm so sorry. Way too many families around here have lost someone that way.
Yeah, something's gotta change. Anyway, now it's just me and my daughter, Jaina. And I just can't bring myself to pack us up and leave him here all alone.
Do you want to go back to Georgia?
Well, that's the real question, ain't it? I never used to like it here. Too cold, too quiet, like a frozen desert. Thousands of miles from family. But these days, I finally started to see it the way Meech did. All the beauty.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I just wish it hadn't taken losing him to get me to come around. I'm realizing now I fought him more out of stubbornness than anything else.
That's gotta be hard.
Yeah. Don't ever let your own sense of what is come between you and the people you love. It's a real easy way to squander precious time.
Do you think you might stay then?
Well, my mama's been making the case that Jaina deserves to grow up with family. And she's probably right. But if I'm honest, the solitude here is a bit of a relief. I don't have to worry what 100 other people are up to. Just, you know, me and my girl. No matter which way I look at it, there just ain't a clear choice.
What do you think Jaina wants?
I think she's happy to be wherever her toys are. But when I think of how close I was to my cousins growing up, well, she may not realize she's missing out, but she will be. You know, I probably put too much stock in chance encounters, but you have any thoughts?
Du solltest bleiben. Das kann ich nicht entscheiden.
Sorry, but
I am so not capable of making that call.
Yeah, sorry. It was a strange question.
It sounds like you've only got good options. I don't think you need to worry about making a wrong choice.
I really appreciate that.
Well, we should get moving. I hope everything works out for you and your daughter.
See you around, Kendra.
You two have a good day.
Ich dachte, wir erfahren ja, ehrlich gesagt, nur ein bisschen was und nicht, dass wir gleich Kendras ganze Lebensgeschichte erfahren, was ja nicht schlimm ist, aber ja.
She got kind of stranded out here.
I know. And her daughter's barely 2 years old. God, those kind of accidents happen all the time.
Das war klar, dass die Kiddies davor standen.
I won't let them take you away. I'm gonna tell them the truth. You swore, Allison. I'm gonna be okay. Please, don't worry about me.
Ah.
I know I'm supposed to get over this brown thing, but I really wish you'd been able to come visit that much.
Yeah, me too, but look, I didn't make any promises that day. You did. Watch.
Oi, wir müssen uns wieder entscheiden.
They all think you killed her. It's not fair. I'll be okay. You have to take care of yourself now.
See?
It's possible. But I don't think so.
Well, I know so. Thinking about it got me through the rest of the day.
Denn wenn sie dies braucht, voilà. Ja, nehmen wir eine Alice-Erinnerung. Es läuft doch dasselbe hinaus, aber Allison geht's dabei besser.
Chief Brown's gonna take care of you. We'll be okay. You'll see.
Kids.
I'm sorry it took me so long to come back. I got so caught up in everything that...
You really don't have to explain. I understand what you were going through now.
Are you ever gonna let me finish my sentences?
Maybe someday, but not today.
Diese, da ist die Laune schon mal ein bisschen besser. Weiter geht's zum Grab.
You think Snowball still lives in there?
Snowy owls only tend to live about 10 years.
Oh, rest in peace, Snowball.
Carol Brown?
This spot's familiar.
Oh.
Man, I forgot how hard Marianne took it when Eddie's mom died.
Well, we were only four, but yeah.
No way. Our box is still here?
We did cover it in like 100 layers of glue.
Krass. Was die Box so lange gehalten hat, 10 Jahre. Ein bisschen erstaunlich, ja, dass sie so um Eddies Mutter geweint hat. Ach, Allison ist dort. Bei der Beerdigung hat sie aufs Meer geblickt, also auf die See geblickt. Da muss ja hier ein... Was?
This is it.
No dice.
Kein Glück. Bin der Meinung, wahrscheinlich. Ach da, Mary.
Where is she?
Nee.
Where is she?
Denn hier.
Where is she? Allison.
Is that her?
What the hell was going on with you? What? Broke?
didn't you say anything? We were your goblins. You didn't have to do it all alone.
Tessa?
Kids, I wasn't expecting to see. What are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Feeling a little guilty, maybe?
Wenn Blicke töten könnten, ey.
When we pass on, our graves are all anyone has to remember us by. Letting hers just fall apart would be cruel. I'm not a cruel person.
Cruel enough to call social services on her mother.
I wanted to protect you. Marianne was getting worse all the time. I was afraid that if things kept going the way they were, then one day...
We were going to end up dead?
No, I won't do this again. I refuse to be held responsible for her choices.
Marianne was fine until you reported her.
Fine? She was getting by on handouts for years. There are only so many times you can show up high to a generous offer of employment. Assuming you show up at all. In the end, she isolated herself from everyone. She was alone and out of options.
She had us! Until you threatened to have us taken away!
I couldn't let her drag you down with her! She had you stealing for God's sake! Your mother never wanted to be a part of this community. She always thought she was better than the rest of us. A spoiled little girl playing fairy princess in the woods. If she just settled down with someone instead of running around with married men, well... Just ask Sam Kansky how much better that would have been for everyone.
Wait, what?
Oh God.
What happened between them?
I wasn't thinking. Please, just forget I said anything.
Tessa!
Sag doch mal jetzt die Wahrheit hier wirklich!
...is whatever went on. Laura left Sam over it. But I shouldn't have said anything about that. I promised I wouldn't. I'm sorry, kids.
Gut, ich will mal ganz kurz mal aufdröseln. Im Endeffekt hat ja Tessa ja vollkommen recht. Wenn sie die Kinder, können sie ja gar nicht beurteilen damals, wie ihre Mutter drauf war. Es waren halt noch Kinder gewesen. Damals als Kind hatten wir ja selber auch nicht den Blick dafür gehabt, was gerade um uns herum abgeht. Gerade auch, was Menschen gerade, sagen wir mal, fühlen und denken. Klar, Kinder sind offen, klar, Kinder sind ehrlich und kriegen viele Sachen mit, aber nicht so sehr. Es war richtig von Tessa gewesen, aber was ich halt wirklich in dem Sinne scheiße finde und für die Kinder wirklich, wenn ich mich mal in das Spiel jetzt so ein bisschen hineinsteigere, ist wirklich, dass Tessa von Anfang an nicht ehrlich war. Sie kann doch auf die Kinder zugehen. Leute, hört mal zu, wir müssen mal reden miteinander. Eure Mutter hatte arge Probleme gehabt und so weiter und so fort. Du hättest es besser machen können. Du hast getan, was du tun musstest. Du hast unsere Familie zerstört. Na, Familie zerstört ist ein bisschen heftig. Du hättest es besser machen können.
I get that Marianne wouldn't let you help her. But there had to be a better way to deal with it. Especially if she was having some kind of crisis.
Yes, you're right. There were other things I could have done. Better things. I know I've made mistakes. All I can do now is say that I'm sorry. If I could give you back your mother, I would. I don't deserve your forgiveness, especially yours, Tyler. But if there's a place for me in your lives, I'd like to be there.
I have to know something first. Are you good with who I am?
I've been thinking about that since you came home. I believe that my life is better for having lived it by God's word. But I also believe we don't always understand what he's saying to us. I pray for guidance. And seeing you standing here in front of me, such a strong and thoughtful young man, I think I have his answer.
That means a lot to me. Thank you.
Tessa, I know the last couple of days have been heated. I'm up for a fresh start if you are, but it's not really up to me. Tyler?
Ja, bin ich auch so vollkommen dafür.
And if we can't let people grow, then what the hell kind of chance do we have?
Thank you. Both of you. Kids, I never knew your mother's whole story, but it was obviously very painful. She always said you two were the only good luck she'd ever had. I'm going to try harder to forgive her. I hope you can as well. If you two are in town tomorrow, come by the cafe. Lunch is on me.
There gonna be coconut cake on the menu?
You know, I think there just might be. I'll see you two tomorrow then.
We'll be there. Come on.
That was something, huh?
Yeah, it was.
I had pretty much given up on her. But I guess sometimes people change.
I know. I feel like a total ass right now.
You shouldn't. She needed to hear all of that.
Yeah, you're probably right. Still, I might bring in a peace offering my first day back. Any ideas?
Jesus stuff?
Maybe I'll just finally bring back that book I borrowed 6 months ago.
So, bevor wir jetzt auch die Folge wieder beenden, wir haben jetzt wirklich sehr viel erfahren. Ich finde es richtig schön, dass wir jetzt mittlerweile so wirklich diesen Entscheidungen auch hineingezogen werden, die sehr menschlich wirken. Man muss sich versuchen, diese Geschichte so ein bisschen hineinzuversetzen, was den Kindern quasi genommen wurde, was die Kinder durchmachen mussten und welche Personen da so involviert sind. Sei es zum Beispiel Onkel Eddie, der Allison aufgezogen hat, oder Tessa, die eigentlich damals wirklich wie eine zweite Mutter, wie eine Tante quasi für sie war und ja, Marianne beim Jugendamt gemeldet hat, aber dass diese zwei Personen wirklich einfach am Ende offen und ehrlich zu den Leuten waren. Ich glaube einfach, dass wir einfach das hier den Leuten das vor Augen zu halten, generell nicht nur in diesem Spiel, generell im gesamten Leben, seid ehrlich zueinander, wo es halt geht. Es sind manchmal harte Worte. Aber seid irgendwie offen und ehrlich. Und wenn euch jemand nicht gefällt, besonders ihr kennt ihn nicht lange, seid ehrlich und dann macht da einfach Schluss. Aber wenn man natürlich so wie die beiden Kinder nicht viel hat und man kennt sie alle Jahre lang, dann versucht man das aber auch irgendwie zu schlichten. Deswegen versuche ich wirklich dann daran zu denken, okay, die Tessa, sie kennen sie schon ein Leben lang, die Tessa kennt sie als Kinder. Da kann man nicht einfach trotzdem sagen, jetzt, nee, ist nicht mehr. Das macht man nicht. Und Tessa war ja auch ehrlich gewesen. Und deshalb, ja, wir gehen jetzt einfach mal, denke ich mal, wieder zurück und dann würde ich mal sagen, hören und sehen wir uns beim nächsten Mal hier bei Tell Me Why. Bis dahin, ja, macht's gut, auf Wiedersehen und tschüss.
Not a bad view, right?
Yeah. I get now why they put cemeteries in nice spots. Takes a little bit of the sting off.
Listen, I know this has been hard. I'm really grateful you saw it through with me. Fireweed was great, but there was no one really there for me like that, you know? You're the only one.
Hey, brothers and sisters, right?
But it's been way more brothers than sisters lately, which is why I'm trying to say thank you.
You really don't have to.
You saved my life, Allison.
Only for you to end up locked up in fireweed for the rest of your childhood.
Wait, are you still blaming yourself for that? Don't. It was my choice.
It's just... I stole your life, Tyler. And then I totally wasted it.
That's not true.
You're on your way to Denali. Michael's gonna be a famous chef. And what am I doing? Nothing.
Nothing. You've been working on that accounting degree. And your art's good. Really good. Stop putting yourself down. As soon as we figure this shit out, we're gonna sell the house, and you're gonna go to Juno. You're gonna kick ass.
You make it sound so easy.
No. We never had a shot at easy. But we always pull through, right?
Yeah. You're right. Hey. Wherever Ranger Tyler ends up next, he better come down from the hills to visit us city folk every now and then. You hear?
For sure. And anyway, that's not gonna be for a while. We've got time.
Oh yeah, of course. We do. So I guess we know the story now, huh? Marianne was done with Delos, and Delos was done with her. Maybe she was too proud, but she worked so hard for so long, and when she reached the end of her rope, no one was there to help her. Not even Tessa or Eddie. When she heard social services was coming, she
gave up. But killed her kids? Really? I don't know. It still feels like there's something missing, right?
You're never gonna understand what was going through her mind. I'll bet even she didn't. It's probably always gonna feel that way.
Das Leben ist so wunderbar, denn ich bin YouTube-Star. Also teilt, liked und schreibt für eine besondere Zeit. Bis bald!